You are so lying to me. All right, guys. So today I'm going to be talking to you about how we know you're lying. Have you ever lied, even just a little bit, to the dentist or the dental hygienist? You know, you come into your appointment and you don't quite tell the truth. If you think that's happened, then we usually know, I will have to tell you, we usually know that you're lying, and here is why. People lie about so many things when it comes to the dentist. I mean, no one likes to be shamed or made to feel like they didn't do their homework as such. And it's sort of like, you know, like that mouse, and having someone look in your mouth is sort of like exposing the truth in some ways. And yes, we do know when you're lying. However, I know a lot of people don't quite tell us the truth. For example, the number one lie I think has ever been to the dentist is that, yes, I floss. I floss most of the time. I floss 3 to 5 times a week. Or they won't say, oh, I floss every day, usually not that bold, but they'll say, yeah, it's like 3 or 4 times a week. There's no way you floss 3 or 4 times a week. Your gums wouldn't bleed. They wouldn't be puffy and red if that was the case. So I know you're lying. The hygienist knows you're lying. But as a healthcare professional, I don't think it helps to shame you or make you feel bad. So one of the things I usually will say, and if you hear me say this to you, if you are a patient of mine, it means I kind of know maybe something's up. But what I will say, and again, for all those dentists out there, just so you can maybe kind of say it in a different way without making the patient feel bad, is to say, you know what, I think maybe yes, maybe that's enough. However, it's probably not how much you're flossing, but it's the way you're flossing. So then I'll get around to it is like, it's all about their technique as opposed to it being about the frequency. So then I have an opportunity for education. I can say, look, show me how you're flossing. And maybe they're showing me and I can always improve on technique. So that way they can agree to me. They're more open to listening to what I have to say, and they don't feel walk out with their tail between their legs. So I do know you're lying, but I will probably do it, you know, try to encourage you to improve your habits in ways that doesn't make you feel too bad. So another way we know sometimes that you're lying is in how much you're wearing your aligners. So have you ever been in Invisalign or, you know, your retainers that you were supposed to be wearing every day or every night? I can usually tell if someone's not wearing, especially wearing their aligners on a daily basis, their Invisalign aligners, and I'll tell you how. The first thing is, when they go in, they don't seat in all the way, okay? So I know there's certain teeth that this can happen to, the really tough teeth for me to actually get going, to get moving. I understand, and I would consider that an exception. But when some teeth are, the aligners are really just not fitting anywhere, it means your aligners are out way more than they're in. And that becomes a little difficult situation because, you know, I want to make sure it's a benefit to all of us if you're wearing your aligners, but it's going to be really tough to turn that around if you haven't been. So one of the things I will say is, you know, tell me about your day, like how long or when you take them in and out. Now, again, if you completely outright lie to me, then I might actually call you out on it because I know. But again, I'm not going to be cruel. I'm going to sort of figure out when are those periods in your day that you struggle with keeping them in. And a lot of times we can work through that and we can figure out ways to help you keep them in more. But it just doesn't do anybody any good to make anybody feel bad, like I said before, but it's one of those things that I can really tell if you're not wearing your liners. So I may actually increase, you may have to stay in that tray longer, or you may have to do some other technique in order to help move the teeth back into the tray. And the more and more you don't wear your liners, the more sort of off track your teeth will get. So it doesn't do any good to lie. You might as well just be honest, and I'm gonna know anyway. Another time that patients lie, and I again, it's always that fear, I think. It's based around fear, and it's based around just not wanting to be caught or to feel embarrassed. And it's a lot of times it's parents. Parents know that they are responsible ultimately for the child's oral health. They're ultimately responsible for what their child eats and drinks. But I sometimes get parents will say, you know, I don't understand it. Like, she doesn't ever have sugar. She only drinks water. Really? Your child only ever drinks water? Like, I don't even know a child that does that. But maybe you have one. I'm just thinking they're probably few and far between. So if I feel that the parent is, you know, again, just complete not wanting to admit that it's a combination of maybe habits, good habits, or lack of good habits, then again, we've got to get around that. But honestly, you know, if there's plaque everywhere, if we see a lot of early decay in between the teeth, that just doesn't happen overnight. And it doesn't happen by just drinking water and eating healthy. There has to be something, and I always say to the parent or the child, I say, listen, I need you to go home and really, really think about what it is you think you might be doing. And I'll question them, I'll give them a couple ideas of what it could be, but if they keep just saying, no, I don't know, I do that, then I know that if they just give it some time and think about it. So try to encourage both parents and children to really understand what's causing it and be responsible for their oral health, because at the end of the day, you know, we all have a responsibility, but no one's going to care more than you. So by lying and not admitting that, geez, you know, I actually don't make my child brush every night, or I don't know, I keep buying Gatorade for them, or, you know, all these things, then there has to be some responsibility. So I kind of, you know, we'll spin it that way, but we really do, you know, dental decay isn't just, it doesn't just get, oh, well, you know, my parents had bad teeth, so I'm going to have bad teeth, or my child's going to have bad teeth. It takes bacteria and exposure to acids and sugars to really break down enamel. Enamel is good, usually, in most people, strong. So not lying about that is just not going to get you far. Another time that I feel that we are lied to some degree is about, you know, how much a patient's smoking. Now, often they'll say, yes, I smoke. But unless I, you know, really probe, well, how much do you smoke? And is it a lot? I mean, it's, if you just say, oh, I don't smoke, I just sort of smoke off and on, or I don't smoke a lot, then that doesn't give me much. So I'm going to probe deeper. So it's good that we, you know, get a really good handle on what you are smoking, because it's really going to kind of affect how we're going to be able to help you. And by lying to us about smoking, which can be an embarrassing thing, and it can be just something that people have a really hard time overcoming, but we can tell, we know if you are smoking a lot more, because we'll start to see bone loss around your teeth. Your teeth will become loose, and we'll start to see a shift or movement in the teeth. There's all kinds of signs. Another big sign as to why you're smoking, or you're smoking a lot, is a lack of bleeding in your gums. So maybe you have, like, you know, bone loss around your teeth, but when I touch your gums, they don't bleed. Well, that, to the untrained eye, would make you think that there's no, you know, there's no gingivitis there, because only people who have bleeding gums have gingivitis. Well, smokers, their gums don't really bleed, because the smoking, the heat, and the reaction of the you know, of the nicotine causes a constriction of the blood vessels, so that you don't tend to get as much bleeding. So again, we will know you're lying, so you might as well fess up and tell us the truth. The last thing is cleaning your retainers or your dentures. Some people will say, yeah, you know, I clean them, I don't know why, it still looks bad, it looks like this, I don't understand. But, you know, when there's actual physical plaque and gooey little white bits that are left inside of your appliances, which could be a retainer or a partial or a denture, we know that you're not cleaning. Now, you may be doing your best, don't get me wrong, you may actually be doing something, but if we're there to, when you come in for these checkups, to bring those appliances with you, anything that you wear in your mouth kind of on a daily basis, it may be just at nighttime alone, just bring it in, show us so that we can help you. And again, no point in you know, saying that you're doing it if you're not. We just want to help you. We want to get you to have, you know, something that goes in your mouth on a daily basis to be as clean as possible, so you don't continue to harbor bacteria and cause bad breath. So that's pretty much it. I think these are the main ways that people generally lie to me and our hygienists. But, you know, we, like I said, we just here to help. There's we usually can tell, so you can't really fool us. And you know, if you'd like to leave us a comment or like let me know something you've lied to the dentist about, I think it would be really interesting to hear that. And if you'd like to subscribe to this channel, I really appreciate it. Until then, I will see you next time.